वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर 10th क्लास स्मार्ट्स, वी आर इन रियल नंबर्स 1.3 एक्सरसाइज 1.3 एक्सरसाइज। आई थिंक सर यू हैव ऑल हैव द टेक्स्ट बुक्स, मैथ्स टेक्स्ट बुक्स। सो ओपन पेज नंबर 12, 1.3, द सेकेंड सम। Without performing division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal form or a non-terminating decimal. Actually, if we do division, we can decide is it the terminating or non-terminating. Without actual division, how can we say? So without actual division, there is a simple form. Actually here 13 by 3125, so denominator is 3125. Division is a small tough division. But without division, what is it? Is it the terminating or non-terminating? How can we say? In the denominator, if the number be, so factors of 2 power n into 5 power m. If we can write the denominator 2 power n into 5 power m, compulsory the given rational number must be a terminating, otherwise non-terminating. For example, we take 3125, write the powers of 2 power and 5 power. 6 5s are 30, 2 5s are 10, 5 5s are again 5, 12 5s, 5 5s again 5, 25 again 5, 5 5s. So 3125 equal to 5 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 into 5. This is equal to 5 power 5. So, this is the given. 13 by 3125 is a terminating rational number. Next, for example, third one, take 455. 5, 9 times, 1 time, again, it's not 7, 455 equal to 5 into 7 into 13, can we write 5 power 1 into 7 power 1, 13 power 1, it is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, so 64 by 455 is not a terminating. It is here non-terminating decimal form. Is it tough or easy? It's very easy. Just find out the denominators or in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. Any of 2 power n or 5 power n or both of. Then only the given is terminating. Otherwise, non-terminating. Again, we look into 29 by Sir Carpenter Children. Take 343 denominator. 3. Not 3. 7. 4 sevens are 28. 63. 7. 7 sevens are 7 sevens are 49. 343 equal to 7 into 7 into 7. This is equal to 7 cube. It is not in the 5 power m or else 2 power n. 7. Therefore, 29 by 343 is non-terminating decimal. Next one. Thirty-six by hundred. You can write 36 by 100 hundred. We can write 100 4 into 25. Next 36 by 4, we can write 2 square into 5. 25, 5 square. This is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. So therefore, 36 by 100 is terminating decimal form. Have you understood, children? So copy down. Do the remaining in this second book. 1 to 10. So again, do all 1 to 10 yourself. Practice. Theorem 1.2, let P by X, let X equal to P by Q be a rational number, such that prime factorization Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power n. That is the first given is 13 by 25. Write following rationals in decimal form. Before writing decimal form, we select easiest method, which is the easiest method to find decimal form. 13 by 25. Generally, very easy to change decimal any number if in the denominator tens, hundreds or thousand, 10,000 lakhs, it's very easy. Generally, for example, by 10, how can you write? It's very simple. We need not divide by 10. 2565 by 10. We divide by 10. 10 means 1 0. How many zeros here? one zero only. So we put decimal left side before one digit only. 256.5. For example, 2565 by 100. It's very simple. Then 2565 12 here after one two zeros. So in the numerator we put decimal before two digits. 1 2. Of course, 2565 by 100,000. What is the answer? Very simple. 2.565. Need not divide. Do the division. 2565 by 10,000. For example, 2565, count 1, 2, 3, 4. How many zeros here? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Put decimal here. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3. Of course, 2565 by 1 lakh. How many zeros here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 zeros are there in denominator. So, 2565. How many numbers are there in numerator? So 1, 2, 3, 4 only. We need one number to put the decimal. So we add 0 left side of the number. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here put decimal. 0.02565. For example, 2565 by 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs. How many zeros are here? How many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 zeros. But in the numerator, only 4 digits. We put 2 extra zeros. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 0.002565. Of course, if we add another 0 in denominator, we add another 0 in numerator. The rule is, how many zeros are there in denominator, we put decimal equal to the number of zeros. Here 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6, put decimal here. Here 5 zeros before 5, 4 zeros, 4 is 3 zeros, 2 zeros, 1 zero. This is the simplest method. Otherwise, if any number is here by 9 or 99 or any other number, compulsory we do division. In these types of sums, it is better to write the denominators in the form of tens, hundreds, thousands or 10,000s. Then it is easy to be divided. Then it is easy to be divided. Copy down, children. 25. 13 by 25 is equal to, we do actual division. Otherwise, if we change 25 100, it is very easy to divide. It is equal to 13 by 25 into 4 into 4. There is a rule. In the fraction, if any number multiply both denominators and numerators, this value is not changing. It is equal. So we multiply same number 4. So 4 13s are 52 by 4 25s are 100. Now it's very easy. This is equal to how many zeros here? 2 zeros. So 0.52. 0.5. We can do like this also. 25 as divisor 13 dividend 0.05 times 125 subtract 5 52 times 50. This also 0.52. Sometimes third one. Two cube means 8. 5 square 25. Of course you can 2 into 5, 3 into, two cube into 5 square. 2 cube into 5 square means 2 cube 8 into 5 square 25. 23 by 8, 25 is 200. This equal to 23 by 200 into 5. 200 are 1000. Now it's very easy. How many zeros here? 3 zeros. 0.135 is the answer. Carpenter children, and do the remaining practice. All will go in the exercise tomorrow. See you. Bye.